In this tutorial, you will learn how to add captions to your videos using the YouTube Studio Subtitles tool. When you first go to youtube.com, you will need to sign into your account. Click on the Sign In button in the top right-hand corner. If you have a Google Gmail account, you can sign in with your username and password. If you do not have a Gmail account and are a first-time user with YouTube, you can click on the Create an Account button to set one up. Once you are signed in, you'll be brought back to the home page. In the top right corner, you will see a profile icon. Click on the profile icon and a drop menu will appear. From there, click on the selection for YouTube Studio. If you are a first-time user with YouTube Studio, there will be a dialog box that asks you who you want to use YouTube as. YouTube has to create a channel for you, or a place to upload and share videos. Here you will want to use your name or initials. Once you are on the main dashboard of the YouTube Studio, to get started, you will need to either click on the Upload Videos button or click on the Create button at the top and select Upload Videos. You have the option to either browse your computer for the video you want to upload, or you can drag and drop the files onto the box. You are able to upload multiple files if you have many videos to caption. After you have selected the video to upload, you will be taken through some steps for setting up the video. On this first page, you will want to give your video a title. You can also add a description and thumbnail for your video, however, these are not necessary. Scroll down and you will see that you are required to select whether this video is for children's audience or not. Since these videos are for academic purposes, select No. Click the Next button at the bottom when you are finished with this page. The second page will have nothing for you to select, so you can go ahead and click Next. This third page is important as it is where you select the visibility of your videos. You have a choice of whether to make your video private, unlisted, or public. If you don't plan on sharing your video with anyone and are just using this to create a caption file to download and use someplace else, then you can select private. If you do plan to share the video through an email or posting a link within web courses, you will want to select unlisted. Unlisted will make sure that your video is not searchable and not listed, but anyone that you give the link to or anyone they share the link with will be able to view your video. Public will allow your video to be searchable and viewable by anyone. After you have made your selection, click on Save. It is important to note that after you click on Save, there may be a small dialog box showing that your video is still uploading. Do not close this box until it says that your video has finished uploading. Once your video has finished uploading, you can select the Subtitles tab from the menu on the left to get started with captioning. If this is your first time using subtitles, you will be asked to select a default language. Select English as the default language. If needed later, you can add other languages within the Subtitles tool. Once this is done, click on the name of the video that you want to caption. YouTube allows you to create captions either manually or automatically. In order to use the automatic captions, you will need to wait for YouTube to generate them. Depending on the length of your video, this could take several hours. You will know that they are available when you see that English Automatic is listed as a language within your video. It is important to note that the automatic captions will still need to be edited. They are not perfect with spelling or grammar, and they are not accessible if left as they are. To edit the automatic captions, click on Duplicate and Edit. This will bring up the caption editor. On the left is where you type and edit the text. You have your video on the right that you can play to make sure that the audio matches the captions created, and to also view how the captions will appear in your video. At the bottom will be the timeline, which shows you where in the video the captions are located, and it also allows you to easily adjust the timing of each. This will be demonstrated a little later. You can see that YouTube has generated captions already, but as I mentioned earlier, they are not perfect. Click anywhere in the box to edit your text. If you finish editing all your captions for the video, you can click Publish. If you are not finished editing the text and need to come back, click on Save Draft. As opposed to automatic captions, there is no wait time to create captions manually. These can be started as soon as your video is uploaded. To edit captions manually, go to the language labeled English United States Video Language and click on Add. The caption editor will open up and you will have a few options. We suggest that you either upload a file or use AutoSync. If you already have a script prepared for your video, you can save yourself time by uploading the script, and YouTube will use this for your captioning. When you click on Upload a File, select the option for Without Timings. Please note that this will only accept file names with a .txt extension, so make sure to save a copy of your script as a text file before trying to upload here. If you do not have a prepared script, select AutoSync to start creating captions for your video. As you can see, the caption editor layout is still the same as before when we looked at auto captioning. You will be given a blank box to type out your text, much like a Word document. You do not have to worry about making the timings or typing your text out in a certain way. YouTube will automatically sync up what you type with what is being said in the video. After you type some text, you will see the captions appear in the video and in the timeline when you play the video back. Whether you decide to use automatic or manual captioning, nothing is ever perfect. You may need to adjust the length of a caption box in the timeline in order for the text to appear on screen for a longer or shorter amount of time. If you need to adjust the length, click on the caption box so that it becomes blue. Place your cursor at the end of the box. You will see that your cursor with four arrows becomes two. Then, click and drag the box either to the right to increase the amount of time or to the left to decrease the amount of time. This works the same if you need to adjust the beginning of the caption box as well. As before, if you are not finished editing and need to return later, click Save Draft. Otherwise, click Publish to complete your video with captions. When it comes time to sharing, there is no way to download the video with captions already burned into the video to your computer. You will need to either download the caption file and upload it elsewhere, such as Vimeo, or share the link to your YouTube video that has the captions, either in web courses or through an email. To download the caption file, while you are still in your video under the Subtitles tab, hover your cursor over the correctly published captions. You will see three dots appear to the far right. Click on the three dots and then select Download. This will give you some options for file formats. You will want to either select .vtt or .srt, depending on which one is needed for your video of choice. If you plan on keeping the video in YouTube, you can get a shareable link to use for posting in web courses or sending in an email. To get this link, click on the back arrow that says Channel Subtitles in the upper left-hand corner. Then from the menu on the left, click on Content. Hover your cursor over the correct video and you will see some icons appear. Click on the three dots for options and select Get Shareable Link. The link will automatically be copied and you can then paste it into your course or email. Thanks for watching!